going on beforehand, which Empire was in, and Alternate graciously allowed them to finish that up. So we're finally into the game that we were all waiting for. There is a draft going on, so let's get into it. So, yeah. Once again, I am Llama Down Under. Once I unmute him, I will be joined by PQMZ, and we've also got Mac Dota on stats. So, hello, how you doing, PQ?
I'm good. Excited to actually get a game going after the wait.
Yeah, we had some... We had some waiting time there, I'm not gonna lie. Not gonna sugarcoat it. Yeah, actually, so... Once again, thank you all of you who are holding out and waiting for this game, and hopefully these ones will be really exciting. Now, just I want to talk about the standings really quickly. Empire is 0-2 so far in their group. Alternate is the last team that they need to face. They're out of Starladder no matter what, but Alternate is only 0-1. They haven't played all of their teams, so if they can get a win here, they can put themselves in contention. But if Empire takes this one out, I mean, then Alternate's out as well. So it's both of these teams probably, I don't know how Empire's feeling after their lost match, but Alternate's going to give it their all. Power Rangers and I want to say CIS Rejects. Nope, that's not right. And the Alliance. An Alliance is 3-0 their group.
Dire team pick.
Yeah, they lost out to Power Rangers and Alliance. Alliance had a day where they had to play... I think they played all three games in one day. It was pretty ridiculous, and they just beat everybody. Yeah, they played really well, and they were all stomps as well. They were not... You know, they were not the close, even games perhaps some folks are used to. They were vicious, vicious stomps. So, we've got a draft coming out in our hands. We've got the IO ban out. Popular ban today, Doom, of course. Thardar, Darkseer, Wyvern not picked up by any of these teams, opting for heroes like Tusk and Bane. And the Dazzle over the Wyvern. I don't think that's bad, necessarily. I know a lot of teams favor having Wyvern pop up, especially with the way you can play her harass the opposing mid a little.
Team Empire's turn to ban.
Yeah. And I think it's something where a lot of teams, as you mentioned, if you're going to give up the Shadow Fiend, you want a good way to kind of maybe hold him in place and destroy him, but you need follow-up damage. Like, maybe early game the Tusk Bane will be enough, but as it progresses, they're going to need something big. So I'm interested to see what they go for. Obviously the Huskar ban out, because you don't want the team to get the Huskar and the Dazzle.
No, she's not yet, at least.
Yeah, and there's still an Alk in the pool. We saw one run today already in our series. Not very successful, but still always, you know, always a fun hero to see. I'm kind of hoping we don't see another one, though, because watching him farm for, like, the next 30 minutes would be great. Sorry, a little bit distracted. There was some stuff in my background. Let's get back into the game. They pick up a gyro. This hero's been nerfed a little. You still like him?
Yeah, I think it makes a lot of sense this game because A, Bane is a really aggressive support early, so if you have a strong safe lane, it lets you around between the lanes. If you pick like a weaker safe lane like Spectre or Anti-Mage, then you're kind of sat with one support in the lane just protecting the entire time. So it opens up the Bane to move around a bit and maybe the well if he's also but, 5 seconds and on top of that he's just really good team fight against everything these days except Huskar, which they banned out.
Yeah, and it's going to be the Earthshaker, probably offlane. We saw this played fantastically this morning by Team Liquid. They beat the crap out of who were they playing earlier today? Team Liquid was playing Team Band English with their Earthshaker. And the Invoker! Empire just ran this! I don't know if you guys got to watch their game versus CIS Rejects or not.
I got to see, like, the last bit when I realized that's the game we were waiting on, but it looked like a bit of a stomp. Completely blunt.
Yeah. I mean, there was a lot of farm on Silent. He's very good at doing that, but doesn't look like they were able to make it latch.
Hopefully Resolution has to remember stay in this game. When you get behind his invoker, there's not really much you can. But Shadow Fiend is a complete tempo to that. You can get ahead, you can stay ahead, or you can come back from behind.
And
Draft looks like it's sorry, go on.
Oh, it's just it's a Radiant Shadow Fiend. Always better, easier to stack.
He's gonna be able to control the tempo a lot this game, I feel like.
Yeah.
If he has a bad lane, Tusk or Bane manage to poke or just come fog and get a few kills with the invoker, then it can really snowball against him. Dazzle's not there to protect him, so he has to play really smart this game. And if he dodges those ganks, he can pick.
Yeah, and we've already seen, obviously it was Jerax on it this morning, but well-placed Ice Shards, arguably better early game at least than the Fissure, just because of how frequently you can use it and the damage output. And it's just a little bit more flexible. It can block people in lane, force them to take a lot of creep damage. But they're going with a Jug on Team Empire, and I mean, that's a solid carry. We've been seeing a lot of Jug these days.
10 seconds. He just fights really well, and it doesn't scale badly at all, especially with people really going for Battle Fury these days. It gives it constant way to keep up with pretty much every carry out there. Reserve time. It also transitions really well into pushing, fighting. I think it's probably one of the stronger carries for this kind of metagame.
Yeah, and it's one that I really enjoy seeing. It's never boring watching a Jug Omni Slash around, so excited for that. Now let's talk what they need to ban out. Do you think Team Alternate is running this as a support Tusk or an offlane? Because they've got options, and they might be keeping it open. Clearly, that's usually what you do at the beginning of the draft. But here, I wouldn't be opposed to seeing an independent offlaner, but most are banned out at this stage.
As far as the offlane options go, there's still a clock in the pool, which I feel doesn't really do too much this game. He can find the Earthshaker or the Dazzle and isolate them. The Tusk can do the same thing, but better, I feel like.
You don't like the kind of insta counter in... A lot of people feel like clock is a counter to SF.
Yeah, I can see that for sure. And if it is a quasi-exhort invoker, it would make a lot more sense because he can set up a lot and apply more pressure on the map. Maybe they look to go that way. Nightstalker wouldn't have been a bad option because it can weave a roll. Seeing to go with the offlane Tusk though. And Shadow Demon's really strong here, I feel like. As soon as the Jug gets out of any slash, you can purge him through spin, same with Shadow Fiend, so Jarrah's gonna get a lot of uptime.
You're also very happy to make replicate the Jug. I guess it's called Disrupt, and then you get his illusions. I've seen those things kill people, and as you said, you can also Disrupt to stop the Omni Slash bouncing around on someone. It's a nice way to kind of escape. This Jug's probably gonna need to carry Dust and be lucky. Because otherwise, a few people on that team have ways to get away from him, you know, Snowball and so on.
Sleep as well, so there's a lot of options. Yep. I feel like this set for an Exhort Invoker, though. Because the amount of setup they have, so they've got Sleep, they've got Disruption, Tusk sets up really easily. Still see the Wex being an option, but I feel like it might be stronger this game. It's how they want to play it, though.
And I didn't think of it before, just because we're seeing so much offlane Earthshaker. This could be a support Earthshaker. I'm doubting it is, but it does feel like Team Empire, they probably, other than their Earthshaker, they have... Okay, you have the stun on Poison Touch at level 4, but they don't actually have other lockdown. And while Earthshaker brings a lot, I do think they need a bit more. And Rubick definitely brings a little bit of that. And he has great spell steal options here.
Yeah, if he can manage to get Fiend's Grip, really mess with arrow, etc. But as, again, there's still ways to save the targets that he rip or sleep or shard in, so not the easiest game for a Rubick.
I think that Team Alternate have done a great job of picking a lineup where they have a bunch of escape options. Like, you are not... It's going to be rough to catch them unawares, especially as the game progresses. But with that, we're finally into game one between Team Alternate and Empire. Let's introduce Team Alternate, since they, having a Tusk, may go for an early gank. We've got Nisha on that Tusk. Shadow Demon's gonna be played up by Elisha, who is already wandering out to lane. Invoker being played up by Supreme. Gyrocopter, Exotic Deer, I really like that name, by the way. And then Robert on the Bane, Soul Stand-In.
For Empire, we've got Resolute Shadow Fiend, Weapon Y on the Rubik, which I feel like is not the name. I could be
That's Aloha Dance.
I thought it was on, I just couldn't. So Aloha Dance on the Rubik, the Stand-In Flow on the Offlane Earthshaker, No Fear on the Dazzle, and Silent on the...
Yeah, and I believe that this is not, I know Funic was playing for them earlier today, I believe he had another engagement, so I don't think he's playing right now, but oh, Nisha, going out all on your lonesome. I'm much more used to seeing teams, they run 5 or 4 with the, for a gank with the Tusk, but... Instead here, Tusk looking to place an early ward. He actually didn't have one. He doesn't have one. Was that the fake out?
Could be some kind of mind games, for sure. But I understand them not going for the early smoke. Their level 1 really isn't that good. But they have a lot of ways of setting things up, but they just don't have that much damage. Side of Jaira.
So, we're gonna be seeing some, sleeping resolution. I did not know, there's some weird particle effects. Bane's just gonna walk it off. A lot of mana use there, but resolution's gonna be just fine. And since he has Dazzle No Fear blocking up his creep wave, he's not even bothered by this, you know?
That's resolution. Actually a really big deal, because A, the Bane isn't mid harassing the Shadow Fiend right now, so it's gonna be harder on the Evoker. B, he doesn't really have too much to do with Nightmare level 1. You can't really trade as efficient, and on that, it's thirds of your mana ball pretty much.
Yeah. Now let's talk Invoker some. Invoker, he's not someone we get to see a lot. This is going to be the Quas Invoker. I too was hoping for Exort. He typically loses his lane. Or evens his lane, I guess is the way to say it. He doesn't win a lane.
He's gonna get crushed. Straight up.
That is one way to say it.
He hasn't got any to start with, and his damage is like equal to Shadow Fiend. And on top of that, Resolution's already got 4 CS, so it's slowly stacking up already. And he's not going to be able to output enough pressure to actually harass the Shadow Fiend off the lane, because there's a Dazzle here constantly doing this.
Oh, there's going to be a... Never mind. I was going to say also, this Dazzle, he has gone first point in Poison Touch. Let's see if we're going to get a second Blood. I don't know if they have it. Telekinesis has a really long cooldown, but the Body Block's coming out from Aloha Dance. Can he get it? It doesn't look like it, but Nisha at least going to be very frustrated. Tries to land the Ice Shards, and they are off the mark. That'll be that. I was going to say that Invoker... Oh, Dazzle is being Poison Touch level 1. That is ridiculous. We never see that.
It makes a lot of sense, though, when you're trying to accomplish what he's doing this game. He's trying to put as much pressure on Invoker as possible and give Resolution the easiest time that he can. But he's stacking, so he's going to be able to get his levels actually either through leeching through the mid lane or joining Shadow Fiend for the...
Yeah.
It makes a lot of sense. And I agree it's not common, but it... achieving a lot already.
Yeah. Another thing I'm really enjoying seeing is we often see Shadow Demon picked up because you're expecting him to be used in a combo pair, maybe with Alina, where the disruption sets up the stun of the other player. But here, he's just putting a lot of points into that poison, and he's really harassing the Earthshaker out of lane. We can see that Flo is having a lot of trouble up there, and they spot this rotation from the Dazzle.
Yeah. It's a really weird build not seeing any points in disruption at level 2, so at least it's accomplishing, as you say. He's trying to zone the Earthshaker out. It's not most effective right now because Jaro can pretty much do it anyway.
He lost a lot of regen though. He is down to 1 tango, right? This Earthshaker, he's one of those heroes where he kind of, his way of farming is he just kind of fishes the wave and makes sure he gets experience. He's not going to get a lot of lost hits, but if they can actually zone him, force him home, he's going to be missing out on experience. And he might try to stick around, but against a gyrocopter, you're always in danger of going down, although they're putting out a lot of damage onto exotic deer as well.
He took a few tower shots going for some CS, so I'm going to have to expend some regen, but he'll be fine. Probably there is none on him or the... bots, so he's probably gonna have to fly some out, which is not a big deal.
You gotta do what you gotta do as the offlaner, that's what they say. Now, looking around, we have a triple, a none. We've got stacks, as you mentioned, by the Dazzle. He's also managed to pick up level 3 just from hovering around in these different lanes, and he's not gimping the Shadow Fiend too much there with that. He's not forcing him to, you know, be super underleveled like we might expect a dual laner to be, which I think is just a win for Empire.
And the entire reason that is in fact he has 11 denies on resolution. The level's like 300 behind the Invoker as a dual lane, pretty much, which is a big deal.
Now, this invoker, he's gonna have to make game impact elsewhere. He, of course, can hope for good runes, maybe get some of his gank on. What's the game plan? How do you get back into this game and be relevant?
You look for maybe level 6, level 7, get your face boots up and carry a TP, and if anything happens in the other lanes, you just TP and be active. Not gonna get anything out of this lane now, except for a tiny bit of CS or some left.
We have a DD... Oh, we have a DD on Bane, they're going for it now. Aloha Dance, he's probably wanting to TP away. There's gonna eat a mango and there's gonna be a spin, but they're dodging a lot of the damage with the snowball, and now they're gonna be snowballing into Aloha Dance. They should have the damage for this. They managed to pick him off. They should be able to turn around, but Silent, he just wanders away, and that DD, it's wearing out. Silent may get the kill on Bane, trying to use a salve or clarity to mana back up, but goodbye, Robert. And Nisha also taking quite a bit of damage. At the same time, Invoker somehow kills Shadow Fiend. Did you catch that one? It looks like the blue balls were invoked.
No, I was watching bottom because I did not think there was any way in hell a kill was going to happen middle.
He tornado EMP'd apparently, so... Yeah.
They just traded some hits or... Something that shouldn't happen happened, which is really good for the invoker because it's on almost level. He's actually ahead now.
Yes.
That won't last for too long because the Shadow Fiend will probably start taking stacks after he raises his way up.
So yeah, Invoker feeling pretty good about that, being a little bit ahead of the Shadow Fiend, but he has many stacks to catch back up for the Shadow Fiend. There's going to be another EMP, more Cold Snap coming out, and Resolution is out of mana just like that.
Luckily, when you have a low mana pool, the bottle helps you out a lot at this point. And he's got plenty of stacks to fall back on, so depending what item build he wants to go this game, yes, he wants the early mech because our lineup's really good at grouping up early and trying to apply some pressure. It's a question of if feels it's better to go for the farming route, like the SNY or the Helm of Dominator.
Yeah, he's got a lot of different options, and I will be interested to see which one. I feel like BKB is needed ASAP, obviously, against an Invoker and a Gyrocopter, and we have Bane with a funky TP out. They're going for the gank onto Nisha. Doesn't have enough mana for a snowball, but needs something to snowball to. Just use it on Resolution. Raises might be enough. One more raise and a Fade Bolt to finish him off. Really unfortunate there, but a heads up play by the Bane, making sure to TP out in time, but immediately they're gonna go onto the Invoke. Oh gosh, there's not enough damage because there wasn't that much mana. Invoker's going for it though. Supreme, he also has a tornado ready. He can use it. I think he needs another auto attack. He does not. And Flo, can he get the return kill? I think that Supreme... Oh, he wanders around. How is there space there?
He's a slim hero, you know? Have a fat
he
box,
is.
Like, fudge.
Yeah, he really works out. It's huge, and also I have to admit, I'm not an Invoker expert, so I wasn't sure that he had the damage with the tornado, but we could see that Supreme was very sure in it, and he went for it, and got the kill, and now even though Flo, yeah, he's leeching some experience here, but if he's not careful, I think he can take a lot of damage from Supreme as well.
Auto attack. He's got enough levels of the Wex, so his attack speed's decent. And Face Boots this early just does a lot of damage. And on top of that Resolution, he didn't finish creds. I don't think he had a healer on him at the time, so he's fairly squishy.
And even without that, I mean, you're a Shadow Fiend. You're an Agi hero that's well known for being squishy. That's your trade-off for being able to farm a crap ton. So, yeah, not having a grand old time. On the upside, Silent, as he always is in every game he plays in, is the top net worth and is spinning onto Awaris Punching Tusk, who is going to get away. We even have TP rotations cancelled from the Invoker. I don't think they're going to go on this one. Yeah, it looks like Silent's just going to fall asleep for a little bit, miss some CS.
I think it's really important he stays on top now because the Shadow Fiend's struggling a tiny bit and Invoker gets off to an early start. Jug's gonna need to be able to have farm with the Shadow Fiend.
Yep.
Both of them have space, I think it's fine. But if they both fall behind and they both go into the woods to get hung, then ATN have the ability to apply a lot more pressure.
Yeah, they've got problems if that's the case for Empire, but we can see Shadow Fiend, he took a couple stacks in the jungle, he's right back up to the Invoker's net worth. There's gonna be another EMP. Gonna be off the mark this time, but Nice little zoning tool he's using there. Silent is really low in health, and you can be Walrus Punched through the spin, but of course he does have that Omni Slash. They try to share it, and now they're in the Snowball, gonna take out the Bane. The Courier is also in the danger zone. He uses the Walrus Punch on the Rubick, gets the kill, but now he has to get away. But here comes Gyrocopter, Exotic Deer, doing a lot of damage. One more auto attack takes out the Tusk. Will Exotic Deer be able to go for more? No Fear is running away, of course, does have that Shallow Grave, and the Creeps, they tank the Rocket Barrage. He's got TP support as well. Exotic Deer may have given up his life, but instead, No Fear, where was the Shallow Grave? Another Resolution, he's going for the razors. He needs two more auto attacks to do the job onto the Gyro, but he stops chasing, knowing that the Invoker's coming. What happened there with the Dazzle?
He was just trying to bait him in, as so the Shadow Fiend got in range to get the razors.
Oh, speaking of baiting, we have Cold Snaps making sure he takes the EMP and a Brain Sap for good measure coming out from the Bane. Elsewhere, we've got Earthshaker going down in the top lane. We mentioned that this game for Alternate, they need it. If they can win this game, they're still in the running for a position moving forwards in the Starladder group stages. Empire's out, so I don't know how that's affecting their gameplay or anything, but this game, yeah.
Something I was going to mention was because Empire lost their game earlier, and Alternate probably got the chance to watch the entire thing. It's going to, even if it doesn't affect Empire that they lost, Alternate will probably be thinking, all right, this team just lost, they're probably not feeling that well, and yeah, we just got to see exactly what.
Oh my goodness. Beautiful tornado into an EMP right as the spin was ending. Silent's dead. They're making sure he's really dead. He's trying to do a bit of damage output while it goes, but instead, he blows up. Can they catch out the Dazzle again this time? Ice Shards are off cooldown. He should be able to land this, and he gets it. No time for a Shallow Grave. Flow trying to escape. And this is a tower as well for Alternate. So they are rolling over this first game. Out of nowhere, the Invoker decides it's time to fight, and they have gotten themselves, probably when things calm down, a nice 2,000 gold lead.
Exactly what like CDEC were doing at TO5. As soon as the Gyro gets to the point where he feels comfortable fighting, he TPs down and applies pressure. They're getting a lot off it. They're going to be able to get the tower, I feel like. Maybe it's going to take longer if Empire defend. But if nothing else, they're getting a lot of kills. And they're making Empire move around the map in a way that isn't efficient for them. And ATN are getting kills off it, so it's definitely efficient.
They've also got a nice deep ward. This is going to help them spot these rotations. They know that because the SF is having a hard time that he's going to have to fall back on the jungle. And knowing exactly where he is just gives Invoker more chances to set up on him. So.
Yeah, this is such an underfarmed Shadow Fiend. It's really rare to see, I feel like.
I think they did a fantastic job of making sure to rotate on him, and really, the Invoker getting one kill, we didn't get to see how the first kill happened, but it's just one of those things where it can really hurt your morale. Suddenly, you just came off the back of a loss.
And maybe it is just tilt, because no way that should happen. Second one was just a really good heads up by Supreme, as opposed to bad play from Resolution.
We've got a Snowball down bottom. We're going to see an Ice Shards come out as well, most likely to keep Aloha Dons in. He doesn't go for it because they were on cooldown, but it's the returned Ice Shards, and here they are. It's going to be one down. Can they catch anybody else? It doesn't look like it. Silent does have that Omni Slash, but it's level one, only three slashes. That's not going to kill anyone right now. Well, I mean, it'll kill one, but they're walking around in pairs, and as I'm speaking about pairs, we're gonna see another EMP combo, a couple more auto attacks. Does he have the tornado ready? He does. It won't kill now with the Dazzle around. Supreme bringing a lot of hurt onto Resolution, and Resolution isn't a bad mid player. Supreme's going in for it. Dazzle, he should have enough mana. There's gonna be a cooldown from the Gyro from behind. Where is the Shallow Grave? It's not gonna be able to come out in time, but the TP, the Echo Slam, they've got the Invoker, they've got the Shadow Fiend, and they have the Dazzle. This is a mess of a team fight. I think they're very happy to finally kill that raid boss, and if they can take Exotic Deer, but he's in the Snowball, I don't think that's where he wants to go, and they're not going to the creep wave. Gyrocopter's gonna fall there. No time to get the sleep off on him. They get the Tusk, and have they just thrown this game?
Maybe not the game, but definitely some of the advantage, and that is Aloha Dance's room that is so well known. To be honest, it's not that hard to steal the shards from the Tusk, because generally the only spell you're gonna get. But he does a lot of work with it.
Yeah.
Having a Rubick this big early is really hard to play Bane against. You get ahead, you're being able to steal all these spells.
And as I was just about to say, it's a fantastic team fight. Oh gosh, Flo is turning it around. One more auto attack and he gets the kill. He's going to take quite a bit of damage from this poison, but he should be fine. He gets the deny as well. I was going to say Flo because he survived that team fight very close to his blink, but then gets another kill to top it all off when it looked like he was going to be the one going down. He is a very happy clam.
And on top of that, the smoke gets scouted out by the ward that the Radiant have around the bottom rune. So more wins for Empire coming out, which is really important right now.
And they have pretty much taken a 4,000 net worth lead, turned it into 1,000. They are doing good work getting themselves back into this game. And Shadowfiend doing Shadowfiend things, trying to work on getting back from being behind. Do you still go for like Assange, Yasha here? Do you go straight BKB? Oh, you go Shadowblade apparently.
Personally, I think it's down to preference and how they want to play the game. ATN are probably going to look to be really hyper-aggressive. Maybe you can look to split push and get kills with the Shadow Blade. It's a lot of sense. Why is it much fighting item? I don't think they want to be like committing to fight right now though.
Yeah, it does feel like we got a big weave coming out. We've also got a nice little disruption and a spin doing damage, but the cooldown is going to completely whiff on, except on Aloha Dance. It's one for one right now. Shadowfiend picking up the Bane, and here comes the Earthshaker. There is the blink. Does he? Where is the Echo Slam? It's not on cooldown. He's going to get shallow graved up. Oh, he's got 12 more seconds to wait on it, and I think they back out of this. But no, he pops from the Shadow Demon Poison, and suddenly I don't think Empire can fight, but Alternate, they are looking ready, missing the ice shards. Will this be the end of the fight? Should be. A little rocket that could is gonna try, but level 1 rocket, not doing much damage.
And it's not the biggest loss. At least they keep the 2-4s alive. But it's more momentum for ATN, and if they can transition this into the mid tower, it's a deal for them. So they can take control of the woods and limit what Empire wants to be farming.
Yeah, so they're going to get themselves a tier 1 off the back of this. Of course, mid always an important and powerful tier 1. Supreme might just go for a tornado, a few auto attacks, and he could get something here. There's going to be a cooldown as well. He's got the cyclone at the ready. That they just go for Aloha Dance, so.
Keep him in. That just created the chance, and it secured the tier 1 as well, which is really smart. Heads up play.
Can we just discuss how Shadow Demon has an Ogre Club?
I guess that's a BKB rush. It makes a lot of sense this game.
On the Shadow Demon.
Yeah, I mean, he's playing the 4 role this game, which I find fairly surprising. It might just be a side thing where this guy always plays the position and the stand-in Roberts, the stand-in for the 5 hit position. As I said in the draft, the Demonic Purge is really good against both heroes. Empire have this game in the Juggernaut and the Shadow. Gonna nullify BKBs as soon as SF get 20 minutes.
It is a good spell, I'm not gonna lie. Now, Shadowfiend has up his Shadow Blade, probably hoping to Requiem of Souls over someone's face from that invis. But at the same time, we're getting the Sanj. I'm guessing what's gonna be Sanj and Yasha coming out of Silent. He might. I mean, Invoker hasn't showed an item past the drums. I thought that maybe if it were an Orchid, there's a chance that he'd go for a Manta, but... Okay, Tornado, a little off the mark.
I think SNY is fine. This game, it's just... better fighting item. Don't worry about Manta dodging this game. Suppose you can take off like one or two small things, but... the Shield Catcher stays on. I'm pretty sure the Purge and Feeble stay on. I guess is more of a farming item, more split pushing based, so it depends how they want to play.
Now, they've got... I mean, it's only an Invoker, but nobody's carrying Dust. The Invoker, he's making sure that they can't tell... Oh, Lord now knows. The Invoker is right there, and Supreme, I think, knows that he's let Flo know. He is still being a pain. There's going to be a Fissure stopping El Lisa from going in, and we've got a cooldown splitting up all of the heroes. Resolution just uses that invisibility, and Flo, he is out of mana, and I think out of time. Oh, going to whip on the Tornado, but do they even need it? Ice Shards hit. He's still taking a bit of poison damage, and they even use the Fiend's Grip. That was a little unnecessary, but having the Earthshaker dead does mean they can push.
Yeah, definitely overkill, because Shadow Demon had that kill through the grave. Not a big deal though. It's only an 80 second... 100 second cooldown, but it's 80 seconds left.
Now Supreme is ghost walking on top of Silent. He is going to be slowed all the way up. If they take an Omni Slash, they need to make sure that they share it. Here comes the snowball. Warrior's Punch can lock him down and he's going to be dead. That's it. That's Silent gone. A little bit uncharacteristic. I feel like Silent is generally a very solid carry player, but I guess just really thinking, feeling like his team needs farm elsewhere and taking a risk, and it's not paying off.
And you can't spin TP out this game because they should have communicated Fiend's Grip was used. Even if
there's
they
still
didn't, there's still Walrus Punch.
Yeah.
Exactly. It makes it really hard for him to that. Strokes are normally fairly comfortable with tower, realizing they've got an out.
Oh, we're gonna have another snowball in, a Walrus Punch, and Shadow Fiend, he's gonna get off the Requiem of Souls with the help of the Shallow Grave, but he's taking a lot of damage from this cooldown. I think he's trying to deny himself to the neutrals, and now the Disruption is making Nisha miss the second Requiem of Souls. No Fear should be going down, but a big Aggle Slam coming out instead. They managed to get the turnaround on Tusk. No Fear ends up falling to the Gyrocopter, and now Flo is in a pickle. He can use that Enchant Totem, though. A Fissure blocking him out. The Omni Slash hitting quite a few of them. Supreme is in there, though, and Silent is monoless. He wants to get the one more auto attack on to the Shadow Demon, and he gets it, but now he's running away. I feel like he could turn and fight, but he does not want to, and now he's gonna go for it, finally. Yeah, and as he pops to the dot damage, and now Supreme may get another kill onto Aloha Dance. He's just going in for it. He's got, of course, the Shadow Walk, and Aloha Dance doesn't have any sort of detection, and now here comes the Bane as well. Can he get it to the high ground? Doesn't look like it. He needs Supreme's help to get vision, and just wasn't there in time, so...
Is under attack. That was really close to Fiend's Grip. I think you click on it and it starts moving away as opposed to actually casting a spell.
Pretty common.
That thing's annoying.
So, looking like Alternate, they have a decent lead, but as we've seen, one good teamfight can turn this all around. They're also doing a great job of warding super aggressively for Team Alternate, so... While we can see that Empire, they don't have too much of an idea of what's going on the map.
They got the one ward here, which figured out because the dust came out when the Shadow Fiend was on the high ground after you used Shadow Blade, so it's pretty obvious to tell it was good that Empire dewarded it, but as you say, there's still two really aggressive wards that give a lot of information.
Yeah, so having a good time seeing Resolution down here, going for that gank. Gonna see if Robert, nope. Get scouted.
That was really ambitious. Walking into the tier 2.
Yeah, I feel like they own the jungle. They aren't going to get punished for that type of play. So, ends up being just fine for them. And maybe they can catch somebody else here. Silent doesn't have the Omni Slash, but I'm not quite sure if they would have taken the timer. They managed to block him in, though. Don't quite go for it.
They don't know where they are shaking. That's pretty much the key here. Like, the last fight where he got the 3-man echo, it pretty much turned the fight and made it even. Until they see him on the map, I don't think they're going to be overextending too much.
Yeah. Now, let's talk game plan. Obviously, I feel like these two lineups are more or less the type where the teams want to run headlong into each other, take a big team fight. But you've definitely got a little bit of split push potential, you could argue, on Empire, just with stuff like the Healing Ward. And I guess Alternate could have Invoker running around with Necro Creeps, although he's chosen to go for the Orchid, so I don't think that's happening. We have a Fiend's Grip just coming out onto Silent. The Fissure manages to stop it. There's gonna be a cooldown, but Silent, he gets off the Omni Slash, doing a lot of damage to Nisha. There is the Disruption, making it an entirely moot point, and now he is trying to spin. A beautiful Echo Slam coming out from Flo, doing mad work with a Tornado, almost resetting the fight. Whose EMP was that? There's gonna be a Requiem of Souls. Everybody on Alternate is very low resolution, just needs to hit a few more people, but here comes Exotic Deer, whose BKB is finally over, and he is being lifted up, but the Ice Shield's getting the kill. Weapon, oh, one more auto attack from Silent should do the trick. We're now two dead for each side, but it's only the supports left, and now Weapon, he's gonna go down. Silent doesn't feel like he can fight, and we got Invoker. He's ready. He's ready to chase.
That Echo was huge, but on top of that, the Snowball just managed to buy them enough time to stabilize. Jaro got his BKB off, and then... See, Requiem of Souls doesn't really matter when the girl is sat in your face, BKB hitting you. Mark
these words. Yeah, it does still give the you do less damage, but the gyrocopter is just it's also only less right click damage, I believe. Yeah, so gyrocopter still has a bunch of damage output from rocket barrage and so on.
And you can win a fight when you get 3-man echoed and all of your supports and the Tusk just skate around on the outsides of the fight with 100% HP and they still feel really confident.
It's the Ags. You were saying, you feel really confident.
Yeah, now they can rush, which is going to be a really big deal.
Gonna be an easy rush and pick up for them. Shadow Demon is going the Ags. That's what the Ogre Club are for. I'm excited.
I don't think I've ever seen this in a real game.
You haven't? It's really powerful, as you mentioned. The Purge does mad work. Gonna have an Aegis picked up by Exotic Deer, who already has BKB, Helm of the Dominator, and Drums. He's a little bit tanky. He's not the tankiest. He doesn't have Sonja and Yasha or so on, but he is pretty big. And they managed to dust out the Shadow Fiend. Resolution's been caught. There is no way out of this one. He's gonna Requiem of Souls on top of them, at least. But Flo, not able to save his ally with Fissure, and we have a very sad Death Requiem coming out.
This Tusk has been on top of him past minutes, I feel like. As soon as he got the Shadow Blade, I don't think it was a really big problem. He could have been closer to his PB, he could have had a Sanj. He had a Blink so he doesn't get caught there. It's really not his game, unfortunately.
Yeah, and it does feel like, I mean, this is the first game in a best of three. There's still a lot of game to go, but it does feel like Empire may be playing a little bit discoordinated. Oh, and I can understand that happening if you've just come off of a tiring best of three, because they were just in a best of three that went all to all three games.
Yeah, I can see that. I think I'd say tilt more than tired, probably, because they had time to have a break between games, probably get their minds right. If you're in a bad mood after a game, you could stay in a bad mood. I don't think they're fired, they're professional players.
Valid point, we've got the High Ground Siege coming out. Exotic Deer, of course, Aegis Carrier. He does not give a damn. And now we're going to be seeing Dazzle thrown up in the air, losing all of his mana. Almost goes down to just the Tornado EMP. It is not a good place to be a Dazzle. Although at the same time, Silent gets top tower.
And they whiff the Echo, Chancellor T. Like milliseconds before you went back to base. That would have been a really nice pick, but now it's 2 minutes with no Echo, and ATN are probably gonna capitalize on that if they saw it. I'm not sure they did though.
Regardless of whether they saw it or not, Resolution is walking right into a trap. Boris Punch to open it up. He's used the invis. They're out of dust. How unlucky, or how lucky for Empire. They had been so diligent about carrying it, and Tusk in fact had some more in his inventory. To go for that type of trap and not have the necessary components for it, always frustrating.
At least the Shadow Blade has paid off once this game. So Resolution can argue it saved him once. That's important.
But Shadow Demon has the Aghanim Scepter upgrade. This means that now you have three charges of Purge.
It's so strong, honestly. Heroes. Him is a really defensive support hero, but when he's put in this position where he can get items and attack levels, so much damage, it's insane.
And as you said, now the BKBs that have just came out for the Shadow Fiend, it's a bit moot.
Definitely still doing so because Gyro's damage is effectively halved. Fiend's Grip doesn't do any damage to you, Tusk doesn't do damage. You don't have to worry about like the EMP, etc. But it's just effect isn't as great as you would want it to be. You're no longer just running around Immortal. You have to worry about this slow, which is going to get 100 move speed.
Yeah, so looking a little bit rough now for the lineup of Empire. They are 7,500 gold behind, 10,000 experience behind. And we can see Silence doing some good work trying to take a tower. Actually going to go for the spin away while Alternate get their bottom tower, and oh goodness, he's run into the Invoker, not the one you wanted to be into. And there is the Orchid that we talked about. The reason I thought he might have maybe gone for a Manta instead, he has a Maelstrom. This is not a build I've seen on the Jug so far in our casting together.
It's a really old build, I think, when people were starting to play the hero again. And Maelstrom kind of came across as this farming slash fighting item that get harder or faster in Omni Slash. Kind of makes sense this game because you don't want to go back for a battle fury when you're this far behind because the fighting potential of the item is a lot less. Maelstrom kind of is an in-between.
It makes sense.
I'm not sure it's the item to win them the game, but...
Yeah, I'm trying to think of something. I mean, it's really rough as you already mentioned. BKB, the Purge doesn't care too much. I'm not sure what item you go here that helps you against this huge Shadow Demon.
I think now you probably just get Scatty or something, so if you hit a target, you stay on them.
I think Rubik is indicating that the entire map is unsafe, but they still need to push the enemy base. I think that's what these squiggles are for.
Pretty much dodge fights, push lanes, I think. He's really close to his blink ball, so when he gets out the pickup, a lot higher. Dyer's the Earthshaker with the Echo. As soon as Rubik can whiff out, it's gonna be a bit easier.
And as far behind as they may be now, approaching 10,000 gold and over 10,000 experience behind, Flo has great item progression. He's already got Blink and Forced Off. That should help them be more maneuverable in the teamfights. Resolution, as we mentioned, has picked up the BKB and has quite a bit more change in the bank. They could get themselves a tier 1 here.
Yeah, it's low enough that they should be able to get it before ATN can port back, but if they opt to set up and try for the fight, then they could definitely buy a campfire here. Radiant's top
tower has fallen. Now, as you said, they're TPing back. They're getting ready to set up for the fight in Empire. They have to see some of this. Can they catch out the Bane? But no. Instead, Flo jumping forward lands the Fissure, and I think the lineup of Empire realized they need to get the hell out of Dodge, so they are leaving on a jet airplane. But of course, Revolution is going for it. There it is. There's going to be the Omni Slash as well. They get two quick pickups. Can they get a third? Bane is going down. Tornado going to slow them, but isn't going to stop them at all. And suddenly, Empire has turned this completely around. Holy Anna, they can't quite get more because that Fissure doesn't latch, but that was beautiful. Just having the Requiem of Souls there and then the immediate follow-up by the Omni Slash.
Custer's Curse doesn't count when you think it in your head, right? I was just about to say, like, they've been playing this game so well, they've been making the right decision, and one bad decision, kind of autopilot Dota, where you're tier 1, it goes down quickly, and then you're kind of just TPing into the tier 2, one gets caught out, and then it's like, alright, we teed here, we want to go catch them. And then you just completely forget that they actually can fight at you if you overextend, or you play stupidly. Now they're back in the game. Achievement, I imagine, after that.
No way near even. While that was a big swing, Alternate were about 10,000 gold ahead, and that was probably only a 3,000-4,000 gold swing.
Okay, maybe a bit exaggerated, but the lead is half.
And it's something where it does feel like when in Dota, you can be behind and still win the game. You know, that's the nice thing about Dota. The Gold Groth doesn't say it all. You can have your Courier die and have your Dazzle die. That drops the gem!
Huge.
Oh no! And now Resolution, he can't be Shadowblading all around. They've got... And I think that gem was just bought.
Alright, never mind. ATN back in control. This gem's actually a real deal.
That gem had just been purchased. Which is...
There's an AC on the Invoker in, like, now, since...
That is rough, and what I thought was gonna be nice and even, when Invoker is a murderer, it doesn't help, so...
Right, it's not actually as big of a deal as I thought, because they already bought a gem on the Shadow Demon, so now that... They have a backup gem, but if you could have stolen one and not had to buy one, it's such a big economical boost. So, small shame.
The bling is also important for morale.
Oh yeah, definitely. Like, Empire will feel like they can't go out on the map for a while now because they're not going to know where the Vision is and they don't have the money on the Dazzle to spamming Sentry. He's trying, but he's just not getting income from Empire except for the fights.
Yeah. So it is rough. Now, Silent, he is wandering around trying to find what form he can. He has 4.3k gold. I'm assuming the Courier was going to get him something. I'm not sure what is the right choice now. I feel like... Butterfly, while it will help you, you're not exactly suffering a lot from right-click yet. The Gyrocopter's still a lot of magic damage over real damage, although he has his own Butterfly, so maybe Jug is forced into a straight MKB. And they saw that smoke!
See, BKB, MKB, Scatty... I think it's just on how he feels the game is gonna go here. There's several items that are open to him, it's just he feels his best. I don't think there is one clear item here. There's so much stuff through BKB, as we've already mentioned. Jara's got a Butterfly, so you're probably going to want an MKB.
Which Shadow Fiend just picked up.
Still don't think that's enough, though, because he's so squishy right now.
Yeah, his itemization, the lack of the Sandra and Yasha is always troublesome. Even with... There are generally two builds on Shadow Fiend that I know a lot of people like to do, of course. It's the mech or and then Sandra and Yasha, or the Helm of the Dominator and then Sandra and Yasha. Sandra and Yasha is in both of these because it's such a great damage and tank out... damage output, tank up item. But...
Probably the best overall item in the game for the price.
Yeah, I think Rod of Atos is close as well, just from a, it gives you so much int for such a cheap price, but of course it's not applicable on as many heroes. And anyway, we have a sneaky Roshan attempt, but I think Invoka might have their number. He's going around, he's doing his ghost walk thing. The Shadow Fiend wasn't in there yet, so now the Roshan will be falling a lot more faster with the presence of the Dark Lord, but they know about it. Both teams, I think they are even aware that Invoka's out there. Oh gosh, they're destroying wards. They've got the Roshan. It's gonna go down. A tornado's gonna pick up four. Flo is outside of it though, so if he needs to, he can Echo Slam initiate as long as he doesn't get hit by this poison. And in comes the creep.
Yeah, I think troll. As long as the healing ward is there, they feel pretty safe now though. And they don't want to fight.
Yeah. Resolution, he's looking to find someone. He wants to- Oh goodness, Invoker is walking down behind them. They might be able to jump and catch him. No such luck. I think they saw him there, so...
Yeah, they definitely did, but... Decision making by him, thinking... They saw this ward get dewarded earlier. They should have known there was a sentry there, and he didn't walk into it. Really hard to keep track of. At a high level, you can do it. So, luckily, he didn't die.
You've also got five players working together, but either way, this should be an easy tier 2, and somehow Empire, despite being quite far behind, they've pulled it back. We're only about 5,000 gold apart, and Empire have cleared all the outer towers. Alternate have taken theirs as well, but considering how far behind Empire were for so long, this is impressive. And we've got rotations into each other. Supreme has invis, but they're all just waiting uphill. Oh goodness, Flo, he jumps right on top of Nisha, and auto attacks will bring him down. Tornado again, catching a bunch of them, but there needs to be some sort of follow-up in the Echo Slam. It manages to catch quite a few of them. Silent, he's going in with that BKB, but he's being purged. He's so slow. He's run back and forth here for the entirety of the fight. And now Nisha snowballing in, still has that Warrior's Punch. Finally, the Omni Slash comes out. The lift keeping Robert in place as well. The Nightmare stopping him, but he should fall here anyway. We've got Resolution. He's about to go down, but he has two lives. He doesn't mind if he goes down here. And Nisha might just Warrior's Punch him up for it, or may blink away. They're still chasing. Exotic Deer is still on the field, but this was definitely a good team fight for Empire. They didn't even lose the Aegis, and they managed to take out one of the opponents. They took out three, forced a buyback apparently onto Mr. Walrus Puncher, and yeah, they got the opposing mid deaded.
All the Shadow Demon ulti with the reacts, so now it's flipped. Now Jaro's BKB is worse, and Invoker also melded to the that fight.
Why did Aloha Dance get that? He's got an Axe!
I wanted to mention that for like the past 5 minutes, but
oh my god, I'm sorry. Yeah, suddenly the game picked up. You saw in that fight how powerful the purge was, so now having it on, I mean, they have it for quite a bit longer. They can probably force another team fight, although only if Aloha Dance doesn't die going in ham here on Nisha. Maybe he just burns all the purges now. Oh gosh, the auto attacks of Resolution are huge. That's mildly disgusting in the best of ways. But, you were saying?
Thank you, Spiteros, right now.
No, it turns out, despite being a strength hero, not the tankiest. I was looking around to see if there are any big item pickups I missed, because suddenly a lot of gold lining Empire's pockets, and now the game is right back to even when it comes to gold and experience.
Yeah, and I think it's actually favoring Empire now, because he's gonna start to scale up. He went for this more carry-orientated build. Right now, his right clicks aren't going to do enough because he can't fight SF, he can't man fight Jug. On top of that, they've got a lot of help from the weave, that's what's keeping them up, so they continue to fight longer. And the biggest initiation is from the Earthshaker at this point, and I think I...
Excellent! I'm finally rid of you. No, yeah, there's a lot of problems with Reborn. I crashed twice trying to load in. Another reason the game was delayed. But I do agree, I feel like Empire's in a really great spot. And especially, I mean, how many ults here can you steal with Ags? How does it work if you steal Invoker's spells as a Rubik with an Ags? I don't know that interaction. I don't know if it buffs them up a level like it would if Invoker had the Ags.
Eggs.
Okay. Either way,
I
have no idea, folks. I'm sure somebody in chat will inform us and explain to us why we're completely wrong. I'm excited for it. We have got an engagement, but they have to be very careful here. I just looked over at Roshan. We've got a little over 30 seconds left on it. Resolution needs to use it or lose it, and he's looking to be trying to use it. Gonna take a bit of damage from the Forge creeps. Gonna steal their souls, add them to his soul catcher. I don't know what Shadow Fiend keeps his souls in, but there's gonna be a Water Punch leading out onto Silent. Resolution taking a lot of damage. He may as well go down here, and he does. Nice place to respawn outside of the base. I think he's gonna be on the outside of the ice shards. Yeah, looks like he's just fine. Gets hit by a tornado, but you know, that's fine. You sometimes have to take a tornado to the face, and that is, I think, very close timing. Good usage on that. I don't know if they can seed here, though. It does feel like they're getting it slowly, but Alternate have a lot of siege.
He has one again in 5 though, so they can definitely close siege.
Oh gosh, we've got a spin coming out of Silent. There's going to be a return EMP, but there are BKBs, and they use the Fiend's Grip as well. But the Shallow Grave coming out, and Echo Slam whiffs completely because the cooldown stopped the flank. Resolution's taking way too much damage now. Warren's Punch finishes off the Rubik finally, but Nisha, he is in the wrong part of town, and the Omni Slash, it's going to kill creeps. It's going to kill a lot of people. Exotic D, he's trying to go in with all of his damage, but we talked about it. He doesn't exactly right-click like a truck yet, and now he has to try to go back in. They're trying to use the Soul Catcher to do more damage to Silent, but he is full health again. Like a Silent would be, and it looks like Empire is going to be the first one to break the base in this setup. No fear doing work there. And they won that team fight without a big Echo Slam because the blink got cancelled.
Yeah, and on top of that, forcing the Shadow Fiend when he was about to die, I think just fighting wasn't unfavorable for Empire. If you respawn on the high ground, they can probably like jump in and kill the Shadow Fiend.
Yeah.
No, that's exactly what they wanted to have happen, but...
Flo was doing work.
Yeah, I'm guessing it was the ocean.
Yeah, so. 100%. So, Resolution is going to be purged up. He may be taking a real tumble here. He's got Dazzle back up in the area, but I don't think Dazzle can get here in time. And Resolution, the raid boss that came into the game a bit later, finally down.
I think Jaro can still win the fight against him, as long as he has help. One-on-one, I think Resolution's right, because of
yeah,
the...
It feels like, okay, so first of all, I just want to say, I have to say that Flo and Alohan Dance playing beautifully this game. I actually think Flo is maybe our MVP, because there were a couple of fights he was in that I would say toning those around won them the game. But of course, Alohan Dance doing a great job of stealing stuff, and Dazzle working on a Vlad's, you know, he's being sacked so hard. But this Gyrocopter, it feels like he needs more damage items. He's got the Butterfly, he's got the Satanic, so it feels like he's got great sustain. Do you think an MKB now?
Even Warren or Rapier, if you can get the Aegis, it's depending on the timing. I can't see the Rosh block, because I'm guessing some debug and Reborn. But if they can time that, I can see a Rapier. More damage gets better.
Yeah, so Aloha Dance, he's going in, he's got the telekinesis onto L. Let's see if L, if they can catch him out, manages to force stuff away, but they use the Echo Slam on two. If they kill up these supports, they might be able to push another lane. And that's exactly what they're gonna probably do here. Roshan, it's a super long respawn. They won't know it, they'll probably check it, but getting both of those supports, forcing buyback out of one of them even, I mean, that's a huge win for Empire.
And on top of that, Rubik got Fiend's Grip again, so next fight's gonna be really easy to execute for them, as if he can get into a spot where ATN aren't able to cancel it, or Disrupt's already been used, or he gets a target that's already been used, can't stop the happening.
Yeah, so for the folks playing at home, if you can't read the clock, it also gave us a pop-up alert when the Aegis went down, but that is a max Roshan respawn timer, 11 minutes. I can see Empire just waiting until they get it, or not, because the Fiend's Grip has been stolen and is being used on Exotic Deer. He's saved by the Snowball Tornado coming out as well to get them off of them, and they've snowballed into the creeps. A nice play there from Nisha, but is there going to be an Omni Slash? It is up, and Silent, he's just going to kill all the creeps around. Walrus Punch is going to stop the Omni Slash for now, but there it goes. Exotic Deer, he doesn't have a way out, and they're going to pick up the Bane as well, who I believe, that's a dieback. Nisha, they're searching for him. Invoka has gotten a kill on the back lines. And this should be the end of that, but they have lost hugely, losing the Gyrocopter off there, and Flo, he gets the Fissure out on Denisha. L is here now to see what he can do to help out. I don't know if they have the return kill, but Aloha Dance, he is in the wrong neighborhood all of a sudden. Two more auto attacks should do it. Oh,
yeah,
there's a gem.
Well, they spot it out, so that's... Side has six gems? No, okay, ATN had both gems, which... it's not too big a deal when Resolution and Silent are hitting your high ground. You don't care about the gem. Point.
Yeah, and it's something where I feel like the gem, you know, it's done its work. If you get a Rax, you're fine with it. Disruption coming out. Juggernaut's gonna spin on his own illusions. That's the disruption resolution. A little bit isolated, but he has so much damage. But even with it all, he's going down, and then he explodes to the Invoker. Yes, they get the return kill on the Tusk, but Invoker very happy about that. And now Exotic Deer is here. There is no spin. There is no BKB. There is no longer any Juggernaut.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Just to be able to gain that position again when the Garo has no buyback and he's dead. End the game. So it's not too bad that they die there and force the buyback out. However, if nothing happens in 6 minutes and Jara is allowed to have his buyback mana back around, then I'd say it's definitely not fair. Gave up quite a bit, I feel like.
Yeah, it has been a top.
At least on the economical side.
Yeah, he's gonna have a long buyback timer either way. He's also now behind on whatever damage item he was hoping to go, which I think will be the MKB just because the butterfly is finished on Shadow Fiend. So that'll be interesting to see. We also just don't... I mean, we're at the point where buybacks do matter, but Empire firmly in the driver's seat. They've pulled ahead in net worth. They are pretty even, actually, in experience considering how long the game is. But... doing really well for themselves, and that is not how that girl should look. Let's fix that one up. Oh, we got a tornado. I'm gonna clip anyone.
He just wants to push out lanes. This speaks a lot, though, that they're scared to push out lanes just in general when they know Resolution and Silent are dead.
Yeah, that's troublesome. Way. And we've got... Rubik hasn't shown us a new item for a while. Flo has now picked up his own BKB, so he's, you know, hopefully not going to get blocked by things like cooldown, but probably predominantly for Gyro output and, of course, Invoker output. Dazzle finally finished up the Vlads, so everybody now hits even larger trucks. And the full Mjolnir, which I hopefully said correctly that time, is done on the Juggernaut. So both teams having a look at the Roshan, which is up, and they're doing it on alternate these items.
It's taking them so long, though. Fight this.
I feel like it shouldn't be taking them that long. Rocket Barrage is stolen. Giant Forge Spirit's gonna go down.
The Jaro's in there on his own, though. He doesn't do that much damage.
This is the problem.
Yeah, these guys kill it instantly, pretty much.
Yeah. Presence of the Dark Lord pulsate. Heaps of damage, but they managed to get one hold off the stage as it's snatched by Juggernaut, killed, I think, by the Warrior's Punch. And now Nisha, he is gonna fold. There's also a Shallow Grave coming out for Silent. He's gonna be fine. But they've taken out Shadow Fiend. He is not going to buy back, but Earthshaker is. I don't know if they can all take out Silent together. Oh, goodness. The Fiend's Grip from the High Ground by Aloha Dance. What a guy. And they've taken out Invoker. I don't think the rest of their lineup can fight. I'm not actually sure how Exotic Deer got under the High Ground. Forced off down, though. Aloha Dance, he can telekinesis Exotic Deer. He can cause a lot of trouble there for him. And no fear is here, just in case as well. The Shallow Grave could come out for Silent. This could just be it. They use it. They don't need it. And that's a 5-man team wipe for alternate. This is another set of racks. They're gonna have buybacks coming out, but as we talked about before, they don't have a lot of them.
No Jaro for 4 minutes on the buyback and 80 seconds in game, so I wouldn't be surprised if they've thrown it here. Resolution quite have money when he responds to buy bots and TP, I don't think. But they can at least get a Rakdos 4. Not to go for the all-in, which is perfectly understandable.
Pretty sure they can get Megas here, though, is the problem. And we're going to be seeing a very dead L, and they may just call it here for alternate, and that will be your GG call.
They did well early on alternate, though. They just made like one or two bad decisions, and Empire just snowballed back into the game after those one or two bad things. So they did make one or two really smart decisions, like that fake pass at the bottom where SF was charged with the Requiem and they echoed and Omnipotent on top of two. It kind of just showed that they're the more experienced team.
Yep. So we'll be headed into game two as soon as possible. Once again, thank you all for watching. I'm Llama Down Under. I was joined by PQ, MZ, and we have Mac Dota on stats. We would love to see you all watching